Till now, we have seen the implementation of linear functions with the help of operational amplifiers. It is also possible to implement non-linear functions using operational amplifiers and non-linear devices such as transistors. The virtual ground property plays an essential role here as well. Firstly, we will see how to implement a logarithmic amplifier. A logarithmic amplifier, also known as a log amp. Here, the output voltage V out. This will be proportional to the natural logarithm of the input. The output voltage V out will be proportional to the natural logarithm of the input voltage. Hence, this is known as a logarithmic amplifier. The circuit diagram for the logarithmic amplifier is shown here. Q1 here is a transistor. Now, for implementing this logarithmic amplifier with the help of operational amplifier, we will assume op-amp to be ideal. That is, the op-amp is having very high gain. Hence, we can write Vin1 minus Vin2. It is nearly equal to 0, that is Vin1 is equal to Vin2. This is also known as the virtual ground property. And in this circuit also, the virtual ground plays a very important role. The virtual ground guarantees that both these nodes, that is the inverting terminal and the non-inverting terminal, are at the same potential. Hence, the virtual ground here guarantees that the current flowing through Q1, the virtual ground here guarantees that the current flowing through Q1, it is exactly proportional to Vin. It is exactly proportional to Vin because no current goes inside this operational amplifier. We can see that the current in this branch is Vin upon R1, the current through this branch. It is Vin upon R1, and because of this virtual ground, both the potentials at this these terminals are equal to 0. Hence, the same current Vin upon R1 is flowing through Q1. Hence, we can write that VBE, it is equal to VT log of Vin upon R1 upon Is. As we know, the formula for VBE is VT into log of IC upon Is. Here, IC the collector current, it is equal to Vin upon R1. This current, it is equal to Vin upon R1. Hence, we get this VBE. As we have got the equation for VBE, we can get the equation for V out, as V out is equal to minus of VBE. Hence, V out is equal to minus of VT log of Vin upon R1 upon Is. From this equation, we can see that the output voltage V out, it is directly proportional to the natural logarithm of the input voltage V in. The logarithmic amplifiers or the logamps prove useful in applications where the input signal levels may vary by a very large factor. In such conditions, it may be desirable to amplify weak signals and attenuate or compress the strong signals. Hence, a logarithmic dependence is required, and hence we can use the logarithmic amplifiers. We can see that this negative sign here, it is expected because if Vin, the input voltage rises, if this Vin rises, then the current through this R increases. And also the current through this transistor increases, hence requiring an increase in VBE. But we can see that the base is at zero. Hence, the emitter voltage must fall below zero to provide a greater collector current. I repeat, if the voltage Vin rises, hence the current flowing through the R1 also increases, and hence the current through Q1 also increases, requiring an increase in VBE. Since this base is at zero, the emitter voltage must fall below zero to provide a greater collector current. This point to be noted, and it should also be noted that the Q1, the transistor Q1, it operates in the active region because both the base and collector remains at zero. Now, what happens if Vin becomes negative? By putting in this formula, we can see that if Vin is negative, we cannot predict Vout, or Vout will be undefined if Vin is negative. Hence, in the actual circuit, if Vin is negative, and as Q1 cannot carry a negative current, this loop around the operational amplifier is broken and Vout, it approaches the negative supply rails. If we provide a negative input voltage, hence Q1 cannot carry a negative current and this loop gets break, and hence Vout will approach the negative supply rails. Hence, it is therefore necessary to ensure that Vin remains positive. That's all for logarithmic amplifier.